Good morning, everybody. Today, I would like to talk about post-harvest disease and for fruit and vegetables. Now, I would like to introduce you about the nature of post-harvest deterioration. All of you know, most of fruit and vegetables are tender and high in moisture contents. So this characteristic caused to post-harvest problem. Cause of the loss, one is a mechanical loss. When we transport or harvesting fruit or vegetable from the fields, so we should be transportation. So during the transportation, the mechanical loss was occur, cause of press task during transportation, but we not visible. But it leads to rupture in the inner tissue and cells. Fruit and vegetables are degradation fast during processing operation, such as we have a polish at the peel, creaming, or process, we will lose of the commodity. Chemical injury. Most of the living thing, fruit and vegetable, is living thing. So they have transpiration and respiration. So when after we harvesting, it's directly lost of weight. And the effect of chemical from the field, when we plant fruit or vegetable in the field, we apply the fungicide, herbicide, insecticides, and also growth regulator or nutrient spray. That all chemical have effect to the plant, to the fruit. So alternatively, the damage may occur after post-harvest treatment. The chemical itself may be present as a visible residues, or you may induce reaction in the produce itself. For example, onions can be serious diffused by action of water on the blood papery scales. For the pathological decay, infection of fungi and bacteria may occur during the growing season in the field, at the harvesting time, during the handling, storage, transportation, marketing, even the purchase to the consumer. Every plant or plant parts are resistant to the attack of majority of microorganisms and by their particular genetic. This is its exception rather than the rule. So although all plants, they have a genetic for resistance, but the disease, when the environment is favorable, the disease will be developed and occur. So how to disease infect to the plant or in the fruit? It comes to the wound, natural opening, stomata, lenticel or hydrotod. And when they entry to the cells, they multiply. Fungals also entry from the wound. And the important fungal is different from bacteria because the bacteria only on the wound. But fungal can enter by themselves directly penetration. They can intact to the cuticle and penetrate to achieve the mechanical pressure. After infection, they produce excrete the enzymes. The enzyme or toxic substance produced by fungi or bacteria also break down cell, plant cell, and kill the plant cells. So plant tissue has several lines of defense. If the physical injury has been sustained, the active process of wound healing will be developed. They make a cocky on the cell for the protection. You will see when the fruit was young, they sour as strings. So at that time when the fruit young is clean, you will see no infection, no disease on fruit. But because it's a very acidity and they have a phenolic compound, you can and for the vegetable, every state of growth when you when you harvesting, it's easy to penetrate or infect of fungi and bacteria. So bacteria is can infect better for vegetable for after post harvest. The water content of plant cell. For the water content of plant cell may be too high or too low to permit the infection. Some of these factors change from time to time. Microorganism you will be see or not see, because when you see the fruit very healthy, it's not mean healthy. They are already infection, but not show the symptom. It depend on the environment and depend on the tissue of the plant. This means latent infection. Do you know latent infection? Many fruits are resistant to fungal attack when they are not ripe or unripe. The infection process begin, but it not show is in latent period. When the process of ripening is accompanied by weakened with cell wall, when the fruit ripening, the weakening of the cell wall and decline ability of synthesis, antifungal substance on fruit, until eventually the fruit is no longer able to resist to the fungus. If the fungus or bacterial infection is will develop decay. So in fruit will increase the respiration and heat production, ethylene production. This one is a decay of lemon. It's inoculated with aspergillus flowers. Some fungus also produce ethylene. Because ethylene, you know, everyone know that it's for the when the mature fruit is produce ethylene, it needs ethylene. So this ethylene is turned predisposed healthy tissue to infected tissue, from healthy to infected tissue. Thus, interaction between plant tissue and microorganism are influenced to very great extent of environmental factor, temperature, humidity, and composition of atmosphere. So the factor of environment will determine that whether, when, how to the symptom will be expressed. Factor influencing for post-harvest deterioration, cultivar. Different cultivar have a different susceptibility. It's different on texture, such as a melon. Melon with a thick skin, so it's difficult to penetration or destroy. So. And also raspberry is a firm texture. It's better for withstand to harvesting and handling. Planting materials. Usually post-harvest disease is not occur only after harvesting, but infect before harvesting, infect from the field, and not you not observe the symptom. So many fungi and bacteria persist on the plant part or plant material, such as in seeds, like the seed borne. For example, onion seeds, often infect with gray mold. And unless the subject to pre-planting fungicide treatment may be produced a crop bulb with neck rot in the storage room. Weather. Unfavorable high or low temperature during growth may be cause of visible injury at time. The result to physical disorder at harvesting. Wind and rain. This picture is, do you know what is the cause of physical injury? Do you know with this picture? Sunburn. And also weather is important for disease forecasting about the meteorological data. In the field, if we have an infection such as a potato leaf blight infection, it will be have a disease on tuber too. Crop husbandry. Nutrition spray affect the incidence of certain post-harvest disorder. If we apply the nematicide, acaricide, insecticide, or fungicide, may be influenced to the level of infestation of disease. And also, if we apply the very growth regulator chemical, also they have the effect for the uniform of harvest maturity and suppress the post-harvest sprouts of bulb and tuber. Now we go to the disease, post-harvest disease of fruit and vegetable. You come to Thailand, this season is a mango season. Mango is one of the most ancient fruit in Thailand. We eat mango as a raw and rice fruit. The mango is very important for the import and domestic consumption in Thailand. We have a lot of money from export to the foreign country. We eat as a raw state. Raw state, you know, some mango very sour, so we cook with a sweet. Eat together, and we have a green mango papura, fresh and sour food, crispy. We eat with a glutinous rice, and we also processing mango like the ice cream, juice, sugar or paste. I would like to introduce you for the raw consumption. Raw consumption. One variety is we call kiosuwei. Kiosuwei is when it's mature, the taste very is sweet, juicy, and nasty. Another variety, red. You know the morphology of this fruit look like rhinoceros. We call red. Red is the name in Thai. We call this. Animal is red and the same look like. And this one is for the raw consumption to pimsen man. It's another variety. This food skin color is light green. And another small one is scale. We use this mango like the rootstock because very strong. Resistant. Variety. For the rice consumption, is nam dok mai. For in the ripening state, mango have many infected disease. น้ำดอกไม้ we sell for export. The color is golden yellow and sweet when it's mature. Another variety is น้ำดอกไม้ number 4. The skin is green, but the taste is sweet as น้ำดอกไม้สีทองมหาชนก3 varieties we use for the export โชคอันนั้นอกร่องอกร่อง is a very old variety very sweet good smell but when the ripening contain many fiber now we don't plant too much but the most serious is the disease of mango disease of mango cause of fungi is show in the fields this symptom is symptom of anthracnose anthracnose can infect every plant part of mango flower stem on the wing and on the fruit if anthracnose infection during the flower stage you cannot get fruit postharvest for the postharvest disease anthracnose will ruin high quality of the crop some postharvest disease damage fruit at ripening stage other disease some show symptoms before harvesting stage So when we grading, we will choose select. Post-harvest disease control in mango to the combination about pre- and post-harvest fungicide application. So we should do the hygiene of post-harvest temperature management. I said that the anthracnose You can find on the leaf, on the flower, and the wings. So, inoculum of post-harvest disease, you will find inoculum of post-harvest disease on the leaf too. Post-harvest temperature management is also important because the post-harvest disease favors temperature 25 degrees during ripening. During long-term storage of mango in the controlled atmosphere, 5% oxygen, 2% carbon dioxide at 13 degrees Celsius for 3 or more weeks. This is appropriate. If we store it in the controlled atmosphere, this is in the short times, we will not find the symptom. But if we keep for the long time, we will find the symptom. The cold temperature, high humidity is a fact of fruit begin reach to the end of storage life and favor for this pathogen. Anthracnose. You will find the sunken black spot appear on the surface of fruit during ripening. This disease most severe in the wet weather. Pre or post-harvest control are required. For the pre-harvest management, we spray mancozeb at the label rate weekly during flowering and monthly until harvesting. And stop spray 14 days before harvesting. During dry season, we can reduce flower space to 4-9 intervals. If rain occurs during flowering, apply perchlorate at the label rate. For the copper oxychloride spray at the label state, used for control anthracnose. However, copper oxychloride could not use for flowering state, where the bacterial black spot is serious. Copper oxychloride can use can substitute for mancozeb spray after flowering. Copper oxychloride can control bacteria, good control bacteria. For post-harvest management of anthracnose, prochlorate spray can be used to control anthracnose. But prochlorate cannot, is not effective against stem end rot. Do you know stem end rot? Stem end rot. Apply prochlorate at ambient temperature. Post-harvest treatment will not provide complete disease control. This is the symptom of stem end rot. This disease caused by Raceo diplodia theobromae or Boteo diplodia theobromae. Fruit will be soft and watery. For Raceo diplodia, we use fludioxazonils for treatment. Arolate for use in heat dip system to use when disease pressure suspect to be low. And the bullet of fludioxazonils for heat dip flow space system when disease pressure is expect too high. And if the disease higher, we use the higher lace. Do not use fruit from orchards with history of stem end rot. Loss of for long-term storage. The severity of stem end rot can be assumed the following ways. If the harvesting 100 mature fruit at random form throughout the orchards, left them untreated at store at 25 degrees until they fully ripening. And C, if one-third of fruit should develop the symptom stem end rot by the time or not. For the post-harvest disease, we have a latent infection such as anthracnose, stem end rot. But when we, after harvesting and packaging, we will have a wound. So the transit rot or lysoplastolonifer will be infection. If fruit was infected by transit rot or lysoplast under the high humidity, we will show the watery lesion and appear the fungus growth on the peel of the fruit. And this disease can spread from fruit to fruit from the contamination packaging materials. How to manage? We remove or reject the fruit that may harbor lysoplast from the packaging sheet. Spray packaging equipment and sheet and the sheet with sanitation agent. Steam cleaning or high pressure hot water cleaning as sanitizer. No fungicides are approved for transit rot control in mango. It cannot control. Other post-harvest disease, Aspergillus, you know Aspergillus niger and mucor, is a transit rot in every kind of fruit, not only mango. But if fruit have a wound, they have a nutrition leak from the peel. So the Aspergillus in the atmosphere and in the room will be, it could infect. It will make the cause of food loss during storage. So how to do? We should careful handling and good hygiene in storage room. Export requirement Choose fruit from orchards with low disease level. Do not export fruit from orchards with history of stem end rot and other disease. Where the poor colors is not acceptable for the import country. The export is not recommended unless the fruit treat combination of hot water and vapor heat. Vapor heat treatment are developed for export market and require quarantine security against fruit fly, but not accept chemical disinfestation treatment. For vapor heat treatment, view control and take note for the short-term storage, but not give adequate control stem end rot. Deep fruit in the hot water at 48 degrees Celsius for 5 minutes, 24 hours before vapor heat treatment will improve stem end rot and rot control. Other disease. These are powdery mildew. Do you know powdery mildew? Powdery mildew like the powder. You put the powder on the leaf. And if we is infect on the flowering state, it cannot fruiting. Black mold. It will look like a dirty on leaf, dirty dust on leaf, on fruit. It's caused by the mango chastic. Mango chastic will produce the honeydews. When honeydews, when it releases the honeydew, it will cover on the leaf, on the flower, on the fruit, and the fungus in the air. Meliola will be growth on the honey and cover on the fruit. It's called black mildew disease. You already have eat a mangosteen yesterday on the first day. Mangosteen we talk as the queen of the fruit. Green one is a young state. It's a healthy one. Today I will show you for infected mangosteen. When we harvesting, we have an index. We will harvesting when it's red with red, a little bit red, and will after on the transportation will be change the color from bright red to dark brown, purple red and dark purple. For the maturing index, the first day of maturing ready to harvesting is like the on the fruit. On the fruit you see this one, green one. And for the mature harvesting state on the peel will like the bleeding, like the bleeding on the skin of the fruit. And from the second day, third day, the skin will be developed and change to pink, to red, to dark red, until to black. If you keep to 14 days, it will begin rotten. In the field, for the mangosteen, we have the disease, infect twig or stem. We call pink disease. Pink means pink is pink color. If an insect infect the twig, because the twig they like the triangle. When raining or irrigation, the water will in the twig, and the disease will be infect. After infecting, they penetrate into the twig, and if they grow the mycelium around the twig, they will show the pink mycelium So we call pink disease. Cause of Clostridium salmonicolor. For the mangosteen, when the infection the trunk or stem, it will be show like the bleeding. Physical disorder of gamosis. Disorder of mangosteen will exudate the yellow latex on the wing, on branch and fruit. Gamosis also occur inside the fruit. However, the is cause of physical injury. Usually, gamosis occur by damage of insects. For the old plant, the old mangosteen will show the gamosis more than young plants. This healthy one. When do you see this one? When you eat in the first day, gamosis. Maybe this one is not infected by disease, but it's caused by the storm or excess of watering from raining. It will exudate the resin or latex. Mangosteen fruit rot. You know, when you eat the mangosteen, you know some food very hard. Do you find some food very hard cannot eat? If that food very hard is mean is already infected with Ratio diphodia. And if you look at the peel, you will see the small back pin dot on the peel. And if you open inside, the pulse will change to brown and it cannot eat. Another one is called for mangosteen fruit rot is a pestalotiopsis, phomopsis. This one is pestalotiopsis and phomopsis. Also, pestalotiopsis also infect on leaf of mangosteen. This one, Lasio diphodia. Today we will see the Lasio diphodia in laboratory. Optimum storage condition. For storage mangosteen at 12 to 14 degrees Celsius can keep for 20 days without chilling in jelly. And application surface cost to reduce weight loss. Another important fruit in Thailand is papaya. We know, everybody know that the very important disease of papaya. Do you know the very important disease of papaya is papaya ring spot virus. In Thailand, we have many varieties, but the good one is cacdam. It's green and red, very sweet, it's strong one. But we not use for export because it's very big. It's not suitable for export, but it for rice consumer. Another one is cacnuan. It's you know papaya salad. Papaya salad. In Thai, very famous for papaya salad. So we eat papaya like the vegetable. We call som tam. Another variety is pak mai lai or Holland. This size is for export. The important disease is papaya ring spot virus. virus infection is make papaya plants stand, leaf red, reduce, not smooth, leaf curl, and this one, this is a symptom. And the color of leaf is changed from light green to from green to light green, like the mosaic. And also infect and show the symptom on the fruit, like the ring on the fruit. And if you taste this fruit, it will be hard and bitter taste. This the virus spread by insect or aphid. Aphids suck the sap of the plant, transfer from plant to plant, and also virus also dissemination by mechanical transmission. How to control? Plant in isolation place, because aphid transfer the disease. For the control, we should control insects. If in this area they have a papaya leaf spot virus, if you plant aphid will be transfer the disease. So if you find one plant show the symptom, remove or destroy infected plant, or avoid to interplant with cucurbit, or use the tolerant cultivar. But in Thailand, we forbid to transgenic papaya plant in Thailand. Also, anthracnose, very important disease in papaya. You will see the, because the papaya peel very thin, so when it's ripening, very soft and easily for damage. And anthracnose is latent infection. The latent infection, the disease infect flower and infect in ovary, and show no symptom until it ripening. It show the symptom on the peel. For the harvesting, papaya should harvest when the fruit peel are orange color, only 10%, or 2 or 3 yellow patch. Cut the peduncle across the papaya trunks. The fruit should not allow to touch the ground to avoid the fungi infection. Usually when we harvesting fruit or vegetable, we not put on the ground. We should have something, some container, because in the soil we have many, many microorganisms can infect. Although it's not a plant disease, but if they have, we have a wound, they can pass through the wound. Heat treatment or water treatment, we also use for papaya. We use 54 degrees Celsius 4 minutes for papaya treatment for control stem end rot. Rambutan. You already have rambutan? Yes. Rambutan is we already sell for domestic, but it's difficult for export because very hairy and high respiration. So if you keep in a refrigerator for a long time, when you put it out of the refrigerator, the hair will turn back. we have two variety. Rongrian is mean school. This variety have show green. The peel is red. Peel is red, hair is green. It's planted in the southern part of Thailand. Another variety is pink or shampoo, pink variety. Pink variety we plant in the east part of Thailand. For the post-harvest disease, we store at 13 degrees for can store it for 17 days. Percentage of disease incidence was reduced and shelf life only 50%. Also, Colectodicum coriosporioides is the important disease of rambutan. Cephalodicum barbellum. For Colectodicum, you will see no mycelium on the wound. But for Cephalodicum barbellum, you will see the grayish brown mycelium in high smudges, in high condition. And also Phytophthora. Phytophthora fruit rot. Phytophthora usually in the soil. It's disease in the soil. But it infects fruit because of when in rainy season, heavy rain, they have a storm. The soil with Phytophthora will spread to the fruit. So it can infect on the fruit. Usually Phytophthora cause of root rot. If you plant watermelon usually touch on the soil. Rambutan on the tree it is very high from soil. I said Phytophthora spread by the rain soil, but some fruit is contact with the soil easily rot by Phytophthora. Are you understand? Because the soil is like the house of Phytophthora. Rose apple. Do you know rose apple? If you store after harvesting, if you store for in the refrigerator or in the stock in the store for a week, you will find the fruit rot. Fruit rot cause of Phytophthora. Green mold. When you buy the orange from the supermarket, some you will find the green mold cause of Penicillium digitatum. Dragon fruit also we will find the disease bipolarist and anthracnose infection. Banana is a very short ripe. When it ripening at the clouds, we will see the cloud rot. Cough, ratio, diplodia, theobromy. Fusarium, many kind of fungus infect at the cloud of banana. Ratiodipodia, Fusarium, Colectodicums. Today, we will see the symptom of anthracnose on banana. For the Phytophthora, I said, Phytophthora is a disease in the soil. Usually Phytophthora epidemic in the rainy season. Because Phytophthora, they have a sac we call sporangium. In sporangium is produced spore, swimming spore. It can swimming. So Phytophthora epidemic in rainy season. And swimming is this spore can swimming to the root, to the plant part for infection. For Phytophthora disease, can infect bean, tomato, and eggplant, cause of fruit rot. I said, and pumpkin, watermelon. If vegetable or fruit contact on the soil, it easily infect by Phytophthora. I said about chemical control, heat treatment, and now we can use a biological control for pre-harvest and post-harvest treatment. If we use biological control spray applied in the field before harvesting for control disease, it will be decreased disease after post-harvest. We can use trichoderma for control penicillium digitatum, cause of orange rot. And also, we reduce the incidence of disease in pineapple fruits by applying trichoderma. When you plant, you're harvesting strawberry, and you keep for 1 or 2 days, you will find the gray mold, botrytis cinerea. So if you spray trichoderma in the fields, it will decrease post-harvest disease after harvesting. So now we, in every department store, we have a QR codes. If you would like to eat the quality fruit or vegetable, and you would like to know the history of planting, how much they apply, who plant the fruit tree or vegetable, we use the QR code for customer tracking down product origin. So now we have many technology for following or tracking for the history of fruit tree or vegetable from field to the table. Finally, I would like to talk that good food and vegetable quality are not only good for good appearance, but they should not have any chemical residues. They are good production from farm packaging, processing to consumer. Thank you for attention. So we go to laboratory to see the symptom of the fruit disease in microscope. Thank you.